It's Wednesday, early in the morning, in Te Ao Mutu.
Oh.
A baby's on its way.
Yes.
In a room full of love and support. Only made possible by an incredible act of giving. You know how they say it takes a village to raise a child? Well, sometimes it takes a village to make one. So these two boys can start a family.
I'm Tamati.
I'm Tim. And we're their dads.
Yeah, we are.
Tamati Coffey is one of our most recognisable faces.
A bit of frontal carnage pushes some cloud in.
Former TV weatherman, winner of Dancing with the Stars.
Tamati and Samantha.
And these days, MP for Wairiki.
I can't finish this without acknowledging my beautiful immigrant husband, Tim. Timmy.
Tamati dropped a massive hint during his maiden speech.
Let's have some kids sometime, eh?
The love of Tamati's life is Tim Smith, a former music teacher from Northern England. Tamati's the life of the party.
No.
Tim's you more of the strong, silent type. Together, they're known as Tim Tam. And they're hopping back on that roller coaster. Hurtling off into parenthood.
It's been something that I've always known that I was going to do. I didn't quite know how I was going to do it.
Are you even in the slightest bit a little bit terrified?
Yeah, I think it's nerve-wracking becoming a parent. We don't know what it's like, eh?
No, but we're really ready for this.
We've come a long way. Same-sex marriage is legit. There's laws against discrimination, but becoming a parent for a gay male is not easy. For starters, biology is not on their side.
Because between us both, we don't have the bits that it takes.
So Tamati and Tim needed to find an egg to fertilise and a surrogate to carry it.
So which comes first, the chick or the egg? Which one did come first?
The surrogate came first.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Natasha and I'm the surrogate.
There are strict rules. It takes a special person to be a surrogate.
Basically write off a year of their life so that they can carry for you. And that's a huge commitment for anybody.
It's selfless, eh?
It's really selfless.
Yeah.
You tie my hair. Where's the hairbrush?
Three children from a sperm donor. Natasha's paying it forward.
Pretty. Yeah.
It's my one-in-a-lifetime thing I'll do. So thank you for my babies.
You sing it.
So someone gave me a donation and I got three children out of it. And it just felt wrong to carry on and not stop and give back.
Perfectly on time.
Surrogacy in New Zealand is DIY. You have to find a surrogate yourself. In this case, these three were introduced by a mutual friend.
Yeah, it was like the awkward date.
I was like, okay, so do I take my medical records? Like, what kind of person are they looking for?
Then we start talking about babies and...
I was like, pick me, pick me, pick me.
And actually, we walked away from that.
Buzzing, eh?
Yeah.
Do you get paid for this?
No, not a single thing. So I have been saving, because I'm a solo mum. I need to make sure that I can financially support my babies.
Next step was an egg donor.
Hi, my name's Danae, and I'm the egg donor.
Danae Bernard crafts sculptures from animal carcasses. She's also a mum of two.
I am getting the gunk out of these skulls that have just arrived. I have a really strong feeling that if you can help people, then you should. But there's another reason that I wanted to do this, and that is world domination.
What does that world look like?
Well, it looks like me.
So that's kind of cool. You know, that floats my boat in terms of having a bit of character, you know. If a bit of that genetics comes through, then I'm good with a bit of randomness like that.
Tamati and Tim now had all the ingredients to make a family with IVF.
Do you expect to play a part in this child's life?
Not terribly. It's not my child. It's Tim and Tamati's child. I expect that they will be 100% honest with the child about where it's come from.
Danae got busy producing eggs.
I can't remember the exact number, but I had something like 40-something eggs come out at once.
31 eggs.
But 14 that made it. We've got 14.
Oh, yeah.
We've got 14 in the freezer.
7 eggs fertilised by Tamati and 7 by Tim. One of those was placed into Natasha, and it grew.
Can I just go for it?
Oh, yeah. Through there?
Yeah. See how it kind of feels like a...
Yeah. Oh!
Their dream of becoming dads was becoming so real they could touch it.
Tim's going to be in the gas with me, and you can catch it.
That's me.
Where's Tim?
Yeah. I'll be lying on the floor.
So who's the father?
I am this...
Tim is, biologically.
This time. Yeah.
Biologically, Tim is. But actually, we're both the fathers. Yeah. And we'll both take on that role.
What I love about Big Gay Out is this is...
At around 20 weeks, Tamati and Tim went public with the news.
...that me and my partner over there, we're expecting a baby in July.
Upstaged the boss a bit.
Were you nervous about making this public?
I was, yeah. Were we nervous?
In a way, we were excited and proud, I think.
When you grow up gay, you become quite resilient and you become quite used to hearing the hate.
Yeah.
And isn't that awful that we just kind of accept it? But actually, we knew that it would come, and it arrived.
Tamati's an MP.
With some of the changes that are proposed around...
His email address is public.
There are the devout, hardcore Christians that think that, you know, God made Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve.
Some people I've seen online, they say that it's child abuse to guys bringing up a baby.
Yeah.
What do you say to them when you get these sorts of messages?
I challenge with love. That's what I do. I very rarely get angry. Tim sometimes shoots from the hip, though. And that's the yin-yang that we have in our relationship. Help me.
Come on. A relationship that's been together for a busy decade. TV, politics, a successful business in Rotorua, this cocktail bar, and a restaurant.
I've never benchmarked myself against anybody else. I've always just thought, this is my life. I get this amount of time, and in that time, I want to do this and this and this and this.
Are you going to have to change your lifestyles when you become dads?
I think we're just going to have to make it work.
When we come back, Tamati and Tim meet their little miracle. And do gay dads get a fair go?
It's 2019. We should be treated like everyone else. Ooh, I love
you. Ooh, I need you. You may not have worked this out, but Tasha's the star of that show.
It's 2 weeks till Tamati and Tim's baby is due.
We're new to this. We don't go to baby showers. Nobody invites the gay guys to the baby showers.
So they're doubling down. Mommy shark, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, mommy shark, doo-doo-doo-doo. One baby shower in Wellington for parliamentary mates.
Tamanagi! Thank you. Thank you for the grape water. Oh, and the little hat and the scarf. Red for the campaign trail 2020. 3, 2, 1. Yeah.
Tim's mum, Christine, a registered nurse, has come all the way from England.
It's a miracle. I never thought it'd happen. Tim's always wanted children, and Tamati. They've been together a long time. old enough and wise enough, and it's happening, and it's lovely.
You can't believe it, can you?
No. They're just born to be dads, the two of them. So it'll be lovely.
The rest of the whānau come out for the second baby shower in Rotorua.
We absolutely have our village around us to help raise this baby.
Natasha, the surrogate, has been carrying this baby for 37 weeks.
There's no room left in here.
Soon, she will have to let it go.
I'm not being naive about it. Like, it's got to be really hard handing over baby, but I think how much joy there's going to be, and it kind of overshadows it.
Tamati and Tim are the lucky ones.
Wow. Goodness.
One of only a handful of gay male couples in Aotearoa who've been able to find a surrogate and access IVF to start a family.
I've just always wanted to be a dad. Getting a little bit... Because, I don't know, it's just something that I've always wanted to be, and I've watched all my friends from school have kids, and, yeah.
He'd be a really good dad. Open plan lounge living.
Brad and Tobias Roebuck Ward are successful real estate agents on Waiheke Island.
You've got the Palm Beach view all day.
A stable, loving couple with two cute dogs. They've been trying to start a family for the past 3 years.
We don't feel like we're equal. We don't feel like we have the same access to be able to start a family.
Very few children are available for adoption here, and finding a surrogate hasn't been easy.
We've had two girls that we've met who were really awesome, that were both told by fertility associates that they weren't suitable. One was because she doesn't have her own children, and the other because she's overweight, which to us felt really, it felt ridiculous.
A third woman changed her mind. It's tough.
Have you given up?
Yeah. I've a little bit given up, yeah.
We haven't given up.
And I don't want to get another dog.
It's not just biology. Gay men also feel the system is not on their side when it comes to making babies.
You need a lawyer to report on our behalf, on behalf of the surrogate. Also, you need counsellors, reports, psychologists, doctors.
Gay men don't get access to publicly funded IVF.
Is this free day now?
Tamati and Tim are spending around $40,000 on the whole process. And the baby's still not theirs after it's born.
Our surrogate, even though she's not going to leave us at the altar, she actually becomes the legal guardian of baby.
They'll have to adopt their baby from Natasha. The boys and Tamati's parents were required to provide police checks before the process was even allowed to go ahead.
But have had to be judged at every turn about our capability of being able to raise children from all kinds of places, like the Ethics Council, like Oranga Tamariki, having to sit in the office and be judged about whether or not you're fit.
I just think it's 2019. We're a family and we should be treated like everyone else. Mm-hmm. It's almost like the law needs to catch up to New Zealand as it is today.
Yeah.
Mr. Speaker.
Someone who might be able to make a difference is the member for Wairiki.
Did you ever think you'd end up in here, Parliament?
I didn't know. I guess I didn't. Lots of people have aspirations to change the world and come in here, and I guess I'm still one of those people.
He may not be able to change the world.
Did the report highlight any risks to the...
But he could change the law.
First of all, that there should be no discrimination when it comes to placing a child with a gay couple. So in that surrogacy process too, that actually the laws that we have are fair, equitable, that the terminology used is correct.
Any legislation is going to have to wait. There's a baby to be born. Natasha is in the final stages of her leg of the journey. The boys are just starting theirs.
Long and slow.
You got my job.
In the middle of the night, in a Te Awamutu birthing centre. A wee miracle is entering the world. A beautiful, healthy, loved baby boy.
Beautiful. Oh. Can you see your titties?
Oh, wow.
Oh, do you cry? Oh, I'm right here, buddy. I'm right here.
Seems so happy.
So it's been quite a journey to get here.
Yeah.
Worth it?
Yeah. Worth it, Tash?
100%. So much joy. It's, yeah, totally makes it worth it.
Look at you.
A family.
It's just perfect.
At last.
An environment filled with love and trust and full of support. An environment where anywhere that child looks, for help or for hugs, and that there'll always be somebody there to do it.